just exploring the data, right? You have to explore the data, any data given for this project. But the Y Finance data, you are going to use that data for to see the financial performance of your specific company or stock. You're going to use that data to find how that specific stock or performing financially. So let's move to today's presentation and you can raise those questions later. Can you all see my screen? Give me some confirmation and let me see. Okay, great. We're going to have a short background on qualitative analysis. It's just to set a background for yesterday's and any financial and quantitative analysis. It's a general introductory session. We're going to see the introduction and what type of quantitative analysis and what analysis can we do on finance. Generally, quantitative analysis is a measure of analyzing data to identify pattern, trend, or relationship. Mostly, quantitative analysis involve with an analysis with numbers, but sometimes you can convert some of the text or other data types to encode them into the numbers and make some kind of quantitative analysis on them too. This will help us to make it informed. Any analysis will make that's supported with data and analysis will make us informed decision and minimize the risk and maximize the return in terms of if you want to interpret it in finance. And any analysis can be done on finance, economics, marketing, healthcare, or any other sector. There are a lot of type of quantitative analysis, but here I bring some of them. Descriptive analysis, it summarizes and describes some data. It gives insights for some description. Inferential, it will draw conclusion. From a sample data, it will draw some inference or conclusion. For predictive analysis, it forecasts future outcome based on historic data. For example, yesterday was mentioned using this stock data from the historic stock data, we can develop a model that can forecast based on this historic data. And predictive analysis, prescriptive analysis, this provide a recommendation for action. There are different concepts that's involved in quantitative analysis. I mean, once while talking about analysis is probability and statistics, understanding the chance of events and data distribution is a key concept in quantitative analysis. This one, the other one is the one you are seeing with Radet yesterday, time series analyze the data, that's have some kind of change over time, and this will try to identify some trends and patterns in those data. A regression analysis will try to draw some relation between variables, optimization techniques, like we see yesterday, we were trying to optimize the financial investments using different portfolio optimization. It tries to find the best solution. For example, yesterday we were saying if you have three stocks to invest on, which one will bring us the best return? We were seeing that this kind of analysis can be done. This is a key concept in quantitative analysis, and visualization is always a key concept in any analysis or communication and to have more insight on the data. Quantitative analysis in finance, like we see some of them yesterday, like portfolio, we can perform a portfolio optimization. This mainly focus on maximizing a return on investment and minimize the risk taken during the investment. And risk management, we have seen RSO, for example, just from yesterday to minimize our risk on investment and to identify the best time to invest and sell our stocks. And we can perform this kind of analysis on our financial data. Option pricing, value finance, derivatives for diversification and other. We can perform a lot of analysis on data, credit risk analysis, credit score analysis for user, and we can name a lot of them. But quantitative analysis is really important in finance. Some of the real world applications using quantitative analysis, for example, we can build a recommendation system for there is a recommendation system for streaming service like Netflix. They might use some engagement matrix or the regression model to find a relation or collaborative filtering to know the behavior of the user. And it's historic engagement with the movies to come up with best recommendation for the movies. Google search optimization, you always use this analysis. Amazon demand forecasting for e-commerce, they might see their sales performance and forecast their demand. I can't see you if you are writing on the chatbot or raising your hand. I can't see, so just open up your mic and we can talk. You can talk. Okay, and we can. These are some of the real world applications. I know you will go in depth with this, and some of you are familiar with what quantitative analysis is. But before yesterday, we dive directly into the analysis. But this is just to set some background on that. Challenge in future direction. There are different challenges involved in any analysis and models. These are some of the challenges. This is my short presentation for the session. If you have any question here, you can raise it, but it's general the presentation. I hope you have some more detailed knowledge on this field, but just to set equal tone among you guys, we prepared this. If you have any question here, you can raise it. Or for demo, what I have done is I show you much of the analysis yesterday. I can go, so I'm not going to repeat that, but I will just select some and give emphasis on how we were trying to optimize the portfolio and something like that. But most of you guys were raising question about this sentiment analysis and the data we give for the movie, I mean, stock news. So I will try to work on that, try to develop some sentiment analysis. I will show you that. Are you fine with that? Give me some reaction, or if you have any opinion or question, you can raise it. But on the quantitative analysis, there's nothing much to show you on the demo. Or should I proceed to the demo? Okay. Can you see my screen? I can zoom it a little bit if you can see. Yesterday we were trying to see this financial analyzer UI file. I try to calculate the stock technical indicators like SMA, RSI, simple moving average, and these all indicators like relative strength index, exponential moving average. These are all quantitative analysis on our data sets. I used TA-LIB for our analysis, and here I use a portfolio analysis tool called Piper. This tool, we were trying to optimize the portfolio or minimize the risk of investment by coming up with some portfolio performance analysis. We can see it here. This is just a repetition from yesterday. We try to see portfolio return, which will give us overall gain or loss of over a specific time. And we were seeing some of this portfolio variability, trying to find the variability of that portfolio return. And this portfolio return, for example, is calculated by using the change in portfolio value and dividing by it by initial value of the start of the at the start of the analysis. And these are what I want to say here. I'm not going to repeat it. What I want to say here is we have seen quant okay, you can continue.
Okay, can you zoom it?
Okay. This better?
Yeah, that's better.
Okay. This is yesterday's session. We were trying to come up with some quantitative analysis to optimize our investment to minimize the risk and to maximize the return. Here, for example, we were seeing the portfolio performance that we were seeing on the example and try to come up with this analysis using different quantitative analysis to we used yesterday. I'm not going to repeat it, but this is the quantitative analysis that I was talking about earlier. So let me go to if you have question here. If it's not a repeated question, you can raise it here. But if not, let me show you a simple sentiment analysis I've done on the news data sets, raw analyst ratings data set. Is there any question? Okay, let me proceed. For those of you who are not on who were not on the session yesterday, the session recording is already posted on the YouTube. You can go and look into the session, and I already shared the notebook and the script on the your technical content folder. So here I loaded. I use. I'm sure if you start working on the sentiment analysis, I try to. I used this na natural language toolkits to for my. There might be. We suggest you to use this on the challenge document. I used that, and it has a function called the sentiment intensity analyzer. And I use that for my analysis. Here I'm setting my directorate. Some of you was saying you have hard time to read the data. I put it in the data directorate here, and I just read it as simple as this. But it's going to take some time, I think, because it's going to it's a large file. So, in the meantime, this is already loaded data. This is the data we have give to you. There is a headline column. Okay. And okay, this is the data. This is a URL, this is the publisher, this is the date, and this one is the stock ticker symbol. And try to, I can't find much missing value on the data. This is the information on the data. Try to come up with, as you see, they are all null values. The shape of the data is around 1.4 million, I think. I was trying to see some of you, I see some discussion on the channel on the dates column. So I was trying to see if there is any data that's not on dates formats, and I can't find any. And for our sentiment analysis, there is a popular data set kind of dictionary called Better Lexicon. Okay, continue. Balaine.
Okay, thank you. So, date format ga malat ne?
Yeah.
Abba aynas yallo direct.
Le ka next kallo data ga concatenate le mareg we merge le mareg ye date formatu yilayayalna ani specific yone date format lemsale year month na date indiset sadergew almost ka allo total data 1,300,000 something data won not value like yarego arna asun ፊል ፎርዋርድን ተጠቀምኩኝ ባክዋርድን ተጠቀምኩኝ ዝም ብዬ ያደረኩኝ ካፕን ማማስ እንትን አናላይስን ያበላሸው
have you set the UTC to true?
UTC true?
Yeah, let's assume this is on UTC, the date and the time is on UTC. I'll show you. I handled that. I saw you discussion and I try to handle that. I'll show you on later. But for my sentiment here, I use Better Lexicon library. Here is the library. The library has it has a sentiment score for different words like this. Every word have its own sentiment score, sentiment intensity score, and these are just some values collected from users about this word, and this will be helpful to you to find out the average sentiment score of that word. So what we will do is we'll look for this words on our, for example, here we are going to use our header, right? So it's going to look into these words, and I will try to come up with some sentiment score for the whole headline column. So here I copied the file for my later use on another variable. So here I initialize the sentiment intensity analyzer from NLitK that I imported here. Here. So I just initialize it. So what I'm going to do is from sentiment, I'm going to add a sentiment column, which is going to be setted using the headline column. I'm going to use this headline column to come up with some sentiment using this sentiment intensity analyzer. So it's going, I think, okay, let's try it. Until it's run, you can read your question here. Up to the point that I showed you up to now. This is not a complete work, but just to guide you. And you, some of you guys was not even getting what this data is about. This. Talk news data we gave you here, the raw analyst rating, CSV, and asking me how are we going to use it. But this is just a simple sentiment analysis. You can go in depth analysis for this, and you're going to model a topic, perform a topic modeling on the headline too. You're going to do that. But Here it's calculating. This is already it's going to add the column and sentiment and will assign some intensity score, or sentiment intensity score for each one based on their content. For example, you can see here, we will expect this to be neutral or positive, but this one will be definitely a negative sentiment. We'll categorize them later, but here it's trying to calculate some sentiment based on the headline. Okay. What did it say in the tallying documents? An LTK or text blob? Iran Dufa, what did the challenge document say on this? I will open it here until the. Okay. Okay, guys, in the meantime, you can talk or write in the chat box. Why are you all not speaking today? Lowell, you can continue. Yeah, you can continue. Well, in the meantime, let me check. The analysis is going to take some time because it's relatively large amount of data. It will assign each headline with some sentiment score here. This is the already run one. Okay. I think you can use either of them, but I will get back to you. But if you use either of them, it will be what we want is for you to come up with a simple or optimized way to analyze the sentiment. It's taking time. Mixer sentiment. You can set what I have done later after I calculate the sentiment score is here. I will try just to label with sentiment category using beans from this to this will be highly negative or very negative. And for a mixed one, it's a tricky one, but you might add some analysis on that, research on that, and always enten balu gin yitakmenyallo ile ahun mixed sentiment sinor men yahal stokun affect yadergwal milon okay yitakmallo yimnamun milon make sure it's useful to check that before investing your time on that, but it's interesting. I add bit adergutna more explore bit adergu will be good. Think to do the sentiment analysis, we should have to remove stop words and other text processing methods. Yeah, that's another method. This is the simple one that I just used, taking much time than expected. It was not, it didn't take this much time while I run it last time. But it will bring this sentiment scores like this. Where did it bring? I'll show you guys. From this, it will come. If we look for this, it's a popular library. You can download it. It will look into these words in the headline and try to come up with some sentiments, aggregate sentiment for the headline. After that, what I just did is try to categorize sentiment in these groups, very negative, negative, neutral, and positive. But you can add by exploring. Just to, this is there was a lot of question coming, and I just want to give you just hint or a guide to follow. So after the sentiment, based on the sentiment, I will assign sentiment category as neutral, negative, and positive ones. I try to see how much of the here from sentiment category, I try to see how much is neutral. And we have around one million of the data was neutral. We have Tosamania Shakawali negative for Chalu. Here just for the exploring purpose. Tomorrow Tchalachu. Because used to the moment, you are open for any analysis, okay? What I have done is last time we were seeing Apple taking performance, right? From the stock, I start to filter out only the upper, the news that I was talking about this Apple stock. So I filter out that and see how much of the news are negative and positive for that. And this is, it's taking too much much time than that I expected, but we will see. So the Apple data, then I try to see how much of this, much of the news was neutral. You can, this is part of ADA, right? So the question is that I was asking earlier, I try to see the data from the Kamachi's data set. I think from 2009 and up to 2020, this is the data we have given you. So this is much of the interest from the financial data. More interesting during this time performance. This is the one that I used to convert the dates, sentiment dates. This will convert that date column into a proper date, pandas data, data time format. I will make the date and time. Then what I have done is I check if there is a null value, and there was no null value in it. Then if there was no null, I was trying to, if it's not that significant, okay, I think our analysis done here. If it's not, yeah, it's done. This is the sentiment. I'll just show you that. Then if I run this, I will categorize them. And I try to see the data like this. Sentiment category will be set like this. Then sentiment count, we can see that here. It's the same. Then I try to filter out the Apple ones like this by setting the from the stock only Apple in the outline at Regiono. Then I try to see the, so I told you, just told you, these are the sentiment of Apple. This is the date time. Just here, convert for about our date column, convert it into the proper pandas date time column. And I will try to see the if there is any missing column. There was no. So I try to separate the dates and time as date time, dates only, and time only. From date column, it will separate the date and time, this simple function. So if I see, I can see the dates here and the time here. So using this and the sentiment, you can relate it with the financial analysis. This is pretty much what I have prepared for you today. You can, if you have any question, you can ask now. Open your mic and speak, or you can just write on the chatbot. Negative and very negative. If the I said some beans, if the sentiment intensity is highly negative, for example, -2 and something like that, I will say it's too highly negative. If there is very negative news about that stock, you can analyze the financial performance based on that. But you can add or remove some of the sentiments. It's up to you to come up with a good analysis for this. Okay, Balani Congo.
ሞክሬ ነበር እሱን የኔጌቲቭ ኤንድ ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ብዬ እና የመጀመሪያው ክላስ እንዳየው ዲስትሪቢሽን ስታየው አንደኛው 1 ቢሊዮን ይመጣል፣ አንደኛው ደግሞ 40 ምናምን ይመጣል። እና ኢምባላንስ ሲሆን እና ፐርፎርማንሱን አፌክት ያደርግናል። የዛም አማራጩ
ምንድን ነው አልከኝ?
አራት ክላስ ሴት ስናደርግ ፖዘቲቭ፣ ኒውትራል፣ ኔጌቲቭ እና ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ስናደርገው ዲስትሪቢሽናቸውን አንደኛውን በጣም ሀይ ያደርገዋል፣ አንደኛው ደግሞ ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ያለው ደግሞ ትንሽ ነው የሚሆነው። እና ሉክ ኒውትራሉ ለምሳሌ ኦልሞስት 107/09/15 ሳምቲንግ እና የታችኛው ደግሞ የቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ስናየው 43 ዲስትሪቢሽኑ
ያ
በጣም የተፋራ ፓርቲ ሆነና እዚህ
ኤኒ
ላይ
አናሊሲስ ካሰራ ግን ኤኒ አናሊሲስ ኒውትራሉ ወደ ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ሊመጣ አይችልም። ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ
ኒውትራሉ አይመጣም።
ኤክስትራክት የሚመጣው ኔጌቲቭን ማብዛት ይቻላል። በት ኢትስ አፕ ቱ ዩ ጋይስ።
ያ
ይህንን ዩ
የስ
ካን
ማይ
ካም አፕ
ኮስቲን
ዊዝ
ኢዝ
ኤኒ ኢንተር ያ
ኔጌቲቭ እና ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭን በአንድ ላይ ኦቨርላፕ ስናደርገው ሞዴላችን የተሻለ ይመጣል እያየሁት ነበር እና
የስ ዩ ካን ዱ ዛት በት እኔ ኢንተረስት ያደረገ ምንድን ነው ኢፍ ዜር ኢዝ ቬሪ ኔጌቲቭ ኒውስ አባውት ዛት ስቶክ ኤንድ ኢፍ አይ ሲ ዛት ፋይናንሻል ፐርፎርማንስ አይ ማይት ጌት ሰም ኢንሳይትስ አይ ዲድንት ኮሪሌት ተም በት ዛትስ ዋይ አይ ፑት ኢት በት አንተም ኔጌቲቭን አንድ ላይ ባደርገው የተሻለ እንትን እላለሁ ካልክ ዩ ካን ዱ ዛት በት እኔ አሁን 100 ሺህ ነው አይደል ፖዘቲቭ አሁን ያለው 109 ሺህ እና 43 ሺህ ዛት ማች እንትን አይደለም 43 ሺህ ኔጌቲቭ ኒውስ ማየት አፌክት ፋይናንሻል ፐርፎርማንስ ዛትስ ዋይ አይ ዱ ኢት ላይክ ዲስ በት ኢትስ ኦፕን ዩ ካን አድ ኦር ሪሙቭ ዘ ቢንስ ዋንዳል ካታጎሪዎችን እየጨመራችሁም እየቀነሳችሁም አናላይዝ እያደረጋችሁ ቤተር ኢንሳይት ማየት ትችላላችሁ። ችግር የለውም። ኦኬ ካን ዩ ጊቭ አስ ግሊምስ ፍሮም ቶፕ ቱ በተን ቱ በተን ዊች ዋን ጄኮብ ንግሲንግ ራው ዳታ ሲስቢ ዳታ ዜር አር ቱ ዳታ ፍሬምስ ዊዝ ኦር ዊዛውት ታይም ዞን thus in converting to standard time format the data set with time zone are assigned to next no I will share this notebook you can see how I handled that as you can see I didn't get any null value here I converted it into pandas date time format it's the date and time format where did I do that? It's here. You just do it like this, and I didn't get any null value in the date. So I will give you this notebook, and you can go. But you can add, you can explore and come up with more efficient method. What is the polarity range of very negative? What I've said here is, I think, below. You can browse for the standard one. This is just to give you a glimpse of what sentiment analysis is done, how the sentiment analysis is done. But I said some bin. I was trying to buy sentiment analysis. Come on, -1 to 0.5. I put it as very negative, I think. Yeah. From -1 to here, very negative. From 0.5 to here, neutral. From here to here. negative from here, this neutral from 0.5 to 1, and I put it positive, but you can explore much on that. Stock analysis, I already gave the stock analysis session yesterday. The video is uploaded and I provide a notebook on the technical content. You can get it there. Jacob, is this a must to use? Jonathan, it's not a must, but you can use any library that's suitable for this. This is just to give you a guide on this. This is just what I will use, simple sentiment analysis, but you can use, explore and come up with efficient way and share that on the on your community in week one channel or resource channel, and you can learn from each other too, or you can put it on the if you come up with any other library or any efficient method, you put it on the resource or week one channel and let the others learn from that too. So if you ask for positive, negative and neutral, you can go with that. I just add negative. I think to do the assembly, we need to remove stop out. So guys, do you have any, where do we find yesterday's notebook? I put there is a shared folder in the drive. There is a shared, the one that the drive that contains your challenge document. In that drive, I put under the technical content folder, there is the one that we gave a session, we will put there. ሁሉንም ኖትቡኮቹንም ኖትቡኩን እና ስላይዳችንን እዛ ላይ ነው የምናደርገው። እሱን ሪፍሬሽ እያደረጋችሁ አፍተር ደ ሴሽን ነው የምናስቀምጠው። ማየት ትችላላችሁ። If you have any other question, you can continue. So if not, we can wrap this session up. There's a morning stand-up, I think at 12:30. Join there, anyone who wants. The Notion link, yeah, let me share you here. Or I will just share it in Slack, or okay, let me share it here. Thank you, Manuel. You can get the notion there, Jacob. So thank you guys for being interactive. I cleared yesterday's notebook. Okay, let me see. Let me share you the link here. You can get yesterday's notebook from this drive. Thank you, guys. We can end this session here and join the stand up at 12:30. Thank you. We can stop the recording. Right. Thank you, guys.